Wake up with Angela Gnote on Fox 59.
Catch the Drew Barrymore Show at 11 right after Indy Now on Fox 59.
A toddler is trying to recover in the hospital this morning after being shot while sleeping in their bed. Amelia Blackburn in the newsroom with more on why police are calling this a frustrating situation.
A man and his dog killed in a Plainfield house fire. Eric Pointer live has the latest from the scene.
We're just about a week away from a potential partial government shutdown. We will check in with our D.C. Bureau for more on the negotiations to secure funding. Fox 59 Morning News at 7 starts now.
From Indiana's number one news source, this is Fox 59 Morning News.
What? 40s? Happy freezing Friday. We're off to a very cold start, but it's Jim's pick of the week, so you know it's going to end up being a really good one. Good morning.
You don't necessarily know that.
Oh, you don't? Hey, it's like 100 and some days since it's been this cold, and I'm off the shot again there.
I know. It's okay, though.
Thanks. 117 days since it's been this cold.
That's a long time, but it's going to get almost 25 degrees warmer by the end of the day.
Look at you, Susie Sunshine.
Mm-hmm. I know. Glass half full, Scoop J.
Jimmy.
Morning, Jimmy.
Hey, yeah, it is the pick of the week, guys.
After did you turn the heat on?
After I did not. Have you?
No.
Me
no.
Neither.
Do not.
I saw somebody do that on the thermostat, and I went, no.
Yeah, no, not yet. Considering what I'm looking ahead to next week with a lot of warmth on the way, you can make it through the weekend without trying to turn on that heater. You're doing something good here. All right, let's take a live look out in Fishers. Hamilton County, skies are clear. We await sunrise about 35 minutes from now. We're in that twilight, no fog issues at this hour, and we are trending cooler than even Thursday morning by 5 to 10 degrees cooler in downtown and out towards Lafayette. We are in the mid to lower 40s now. As Ange pointed out, the coolest start in 117 days. Have to go back to May 30th since we've been this chilly here in downtown. Radar's dry, and it's going to stay that way right on through the afternoon and evening. Make it a good one and make it outside for today. We'll take a look at our timeline. I think we top out in the mid to lower 70s this afternoon. We'll have much more on your Friday night forecast, and we are timing out rain early tomorrow morning. We'll have the latest on that in just a couple minutes. Let's talk traffic now in the new hour. Britt's got the latest on our roadways.
The Traffic Authority, powered by Tom Wood Automotive.
701 and a couple of interstate crashes that we're watching right now. Both of them on I-65, quite a ways from each other, though. This one, I-65 at 21st Street, blocking that right lane partially, and then also the entrance ramp from 30th Street to southbound I-65 partially blocked as well. And we're starting to see some heavier volume from the northwest side towards the downtown area heading this direction, southbound I-65. So we are dealing with some minor slowing around that crash activity, but it gets moving pretty quickly again past that crash and into the downtown area. Looking at the big picture, in and around 465, that's really the only problem that we have. But farther north, if you know anyone heading down from Lafayette, we've got southbound I-65 blocked at State Road 16 because of a crash involving a semi. We are getting busier here on the south side too for our Friday morning rush hour. I-65 at 465, still going the speed limit here on the south side though. Angela.
All right, Britt, thank you. This morning, police working to find out who shot into an Indianapolis home. This hit a toddler in the leg while he was sleeping in his own bed.
Our Leah Blackburn is in the newsroom now. Leah, do we know how old the child is and also their condition this morning?
Well, IMPD says the boy is roughly 2 years old. We're working to learn his exact condition, but police say he is stable at Riley Hospital. It happened around 11:30 last night. Police say someone